welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Washington State is lined up to kick the ball off first, and we are ready to go. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. He gets out to about the 28-yard line.
The 37-yard line.
You're always looking for ways to get your playmakers involved, whether it's handing it off or just throwing it to them.
Nice run up the middle. That makes it 7-6. And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That's a gain of 4 on the play.
I think you got to give credit to the big boys up front there. They're able to get this back to room that he needed. Get set for the next play.
That'll bring up 2nd and 12.
From their own 48-yard line, 2nd down. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. And this play is number 8 on the drive. The catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. And he just gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
2nd down, 10 to go. Ball on the 31. Flips it middle to the running back. Tackle around the 36-yard line.
Any offense is predicated on being able to move efficiently like this.
That'll make it 35.
He scrambled. Throws it, and it's tipped away. That's going to bring up 4th down.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
They bring him down, and they bring him down hard on that one. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. Quick throw to the tight end. He gets hit out of bounds at the 49-yard line.
Tight ends can can really be a wild card in any offense. Sometimes the defense are a little bit confused on how to handle it.
Fires in a hurry. Interception.
He telegraphed that throw. He eyed his receiver the whole way. That was an easy read by the defense.
First and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. Quick throw out to the receiver. He has some room. And they push him out at the 43. Nice looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here. And again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 34.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that these defense is putting on him.
Slings it out there incomplete.
Brad, I don't know about you, but it looked to me that they just miscommunicated. It looked like the wide receiver was going in one direction and the quarterback was throwing it another direction. They definitely need to get on the same page.
He launches one for the end zone, and it's intercepted by the senior quarterback. And the quarterback just can't believe it. He really wishes he could have that one back.
Every quarterback has passes that he wishes he could have back. However, hey, a pick is a pick, and no one is going to care how bad he wants that one back.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. Zips it to the tight end. Tackle made right around the 22-yard line. The 26-yard line. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He's pushed out of bounds at the 32-yard line.
Usually a defense will look to kind of have a feel based on the tendencies and research that they have done throughout the week to be able to see when a screen might be coming. But truly, you have to be able to get your eyes on the quarterback and just sense the timing is a little bit different. That offensive lineman let me get by a little bit too easily, and that should be something needs to tip the hand of the offense to let you know that a screen is coming.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. Tipped away.
Excellent pass defense. Got to be able to make a lightning quick reaction to bat the ball away like he did right there.
This is the eighth play of this drive. And he throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Neither offense can find any kind of rhythm so far.
Yeah, almost feels like the two offenses are just kind of feeling their way right now, allowing both these defenses just to dominate the game.
Well, let's see if he can shake off that pick that he tossed last time out.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
They go with the back, and he's hammered in the backfield. Second down. Defense will be digging in here as they're inside their own five. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. And he is drilled at the two. He's to the 10. And they make the stop at the 22. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He's to the 40. And hauls it in. And down he goes at the 48-yard line. We've played one. Still no score.
That makes it first and 10.
Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play. To the back quickly, off his hands, incomplete. And here's another third down. Fires it out. And he's tackled at the 45-yard line. The defense didn't stop the pass, but they stopped him short of the sticks.
And that's the important thing here. Allow him to make the catch, but make sure you tackle him before he gets to the first down marker.
In a perfect world, he knocks this kick down inside the 10. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. The 30. Across midfield, and they finally bring him down at the 46-yard line.
Boy, everything seemed to come together on that play. They had the right call, good blocking, and an excellent run all on one down.
Quick strike, and he drops it. From the 46-yard line, second down. Bring him down right around the 38-yard line.
That'll bring up 32.
They tackle him there, and he's still going to be short.
You know, a lot of times coaches look to linebackers for leadership on defense. And on that tackle, he showed you why that's the case.
So they're going to go for it here. Run up the middle, and that keeps the drive alive on that fourth down conversion.
How about the call there by the offensive coordinator, and great execution up front by the offensive line.
And he just gets rid of it.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Here we go.
For the corner, and he's taken down around the 22-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Set check, green 90.
makes it to the 14. Makes it to the 5. Up the middle for a nice game. Touchdown, Orange. Converts the extra point. It was an 11-play, 80-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running back.
He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
I just love to watch this defense play. They've been flying all over the field today, making big play after big play. The crazy thing is, we still have such a close game despite how well they play.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Zips it to the back. Down, right around the 26-yard line. Throws this one away. From their own 26-yard line. Third down. Throws it in a hurry. And he hits him hard at the 32. It'll be short of the first after the completion.
Well, good effort by the defense to make sure they got him before he got to the marker.
Shoved out of bounds around the 47-yard line. You know, we're getting so used to pinball football with a lot of points. Kind of fun to see defenses play this way.
Kind of refreshing, isn't it? I mean, every single week we call games and you're seeing scores in the 30s and 40s. This is one of those low-scoring games. Which offense will get that big break eventually could be the team that wins it.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He gets rid of this one.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Throws it out and it falls incomplete. Third down and they need to get it inside the 43. Syracuse is up 7. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. He's tackled at the 40-yard line. Nice run there. Great tackle at the 33. He gets out to about the 32-yard line. There's a player hurt. It doesn't look to be that bad. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field.
tackles him hard at the 22-yard line.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 22. Gets it. He's in space. Tackle at the 14.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
Syracuse up 7 points. Puts it right in his hands. Touchdown.
A good football team has to consistently be able to capitalize when they're in the red zone.
PAT. A 9-play, 52-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. It out maybe to the 26-yard line.
That's a gain of 1 on the play. That brings up second and 9.
We're halfway through, and it's been a good one. Syracuse lead is 2 touchdowns.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here completely locked in on that first half. The passing numbers put up in the first half are hardly gaudy, less than 6 yards per pass for these two teams. So you look at it and you want your quarterback to take care of the ball. Turnovers are killers. I get that. A little too conservative in the first half. The quarterback, you want him to be a little bit more aggressive out there?
Well, if you're not, then it's going to make it extremely easy on the defense. And I say that because if you don't push the ball down the field, I don't have to respect the whole field. There's a reason the field's 52-plus yards wide and 100 yards long. I mean, if you make me honor that and you throw it down the field 30 or 40 yards and you make me run all the way down there and cover that area as well, it makes it a lot harder on a defense. Right now, the passes are so short, you're only making me cover 30, 40 yards. It makes it easy on a defense. The pass rush, you get your hands up and try to deflect balls. You know the ball's coming out early. It makes everything extremely simple on a defense when you make passes just dink and dunk.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. Going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Syracuse continuing to play extremely tough defense. This has been impressive.
It's just been impressive to watch them play with such an attitude, almost a chip on their shoulder with the energy that they're playing with. And I think it's going to require that kind of effort to be able to win this game.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Slings it. He's taken down right around the 30. And he just gets rid of it. From their own 30-yard line. Third down. Throws left. The running back's got it. They'll get him for a loss. gets away, and it's a booming punt. Looking for the corner, and he makes it out to about the 41-yard line. The offense will take the field, and they've been moving the ball very well on their last couple of drives. Man open, incomplete. From their own 41-yard line. Second down. Quick pass. Tackle made around the 48-yard line. That's a game of seven. Third down.
It's our time. It's our time.
They bring him down in the backfield. The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one.
No matter how much people want to talk about points and offense, I still think that the best offense is a great defense. When you put a zero up there, it makes it pretty easy on your own offense to go out there and win the game.
The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
Very good tackle in space. Passes it to the middle of the field, and they make the stop at the 31. He's under some heat. Lost the ball. Fumbled. Tackled for a loss. They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. It quickly, and he's tackled at about the 27-yard line.
Excellent execution on one side of the ball that time, and it looks to me like the defense was in a little state of confusion. Let's see if they can pull themselves together.
And he's hit immediately.
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
And it takes some real accuracy on those deep corner routes. So kudos to the quarterback. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A nice 7-play, 80-yard drive. And they put up 7 points.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
Washington State to kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They couldn't get anything going on that last drive. Syracuse is up a score.
his way to the 33-yard line. Midfield, and they push him out at the 40. A strike over the middle, and he's hit before he can go anywhere. He makes his way out to about the 12. From the 12-yard line, first down. It up the middle for a nice run.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
And they get nice yardage on that run. Syracuse is up by a touchdown. So they're going to send this one upstairs and try to determine exactly where they should spot the ball. So the coach wanted this challenge, and Kirk, I really don't understand this one.
I got to be honest, Brad, I'm a little confused. I'm not quite sure why the coach wanted to challenge this one, because he doesn't really gain or lose anything by it.
So the call on the field will be reversed. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Here we go!
Touchdown, Orange!
This kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
And he tacks on the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 3. Across the 30. Brought down at the 40-yard line. They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop them this time.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
He
catches one for the end zone.
You like a team that's ready to defend the pass. It takes some preparation to get in the way of a pass like that.
From the 23-yard line, it's second down.
He's got it with room to run. He steps out right around the 18-yard line. They come out on an empty backfield. So at the end of the third quarter, the Orange lead 21-7. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
Fourth quarter. They've got the lead. They're going to get the football back, but there's still a lot of ball left. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. What a play, and that is first and goal. Inside the 10-yard line. It's second down. Quick throw to the back. It's incomplete.
Well, that was clearly a poor read on somebody's part. And the bad news is there was no defender around. If the pass was anywhere near him, it could have gone for a big play.
Plenty of time in the pocket. It's fourth and goal, and here they go from the 8-yard line. Pressure coming. Finds the halfback in the end zone. Touchdown. And he converts the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Fielded at the 2. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line.
Well, this is turning into a shootout here. Now, remember, the last time we saw this offense out on the field, they answered the bell and scored a touchdown. Can they do that now a second time?
A score here might effectively end this one. Syracuse is up 7. Right around the 28-yard line.
That's a deep one. That'll make it second and inches.
They hand it off, and he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. To about the 34-yard line. On the ground with the tailback. And he hits him hard at the 37. Right around the 40.
tackle at the 33. Made a few guys miss on his way to a quality return. This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Just under three to go in regulation. From their own 33-yard line, second down. Got it, and he goes down quickly.
Nothing flashy at all, but now that first down marker is a lot closer.
Tackles him hard at the 47. Just put away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
From their own 47-yard line. Second down. There's a strike complete. He's taken down at the 44. He's tackled in the open field. The catch and look out. Tackle made the 24-yard line. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Throws it in a hurry. Nice play to set up first and goal.
You know, having a playmaker tight end makes those think twice before they make a move. That could be just enough time for the quarterback.
It out left to the running back, and they make the stop, the 7-yard line.
That brings him second and goal.
It's second and goal, 7 yards for the touchdown. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. The play clock double zero. They just took too long.
Offense.
A little over a minute in the game. He makes the PAT. And it looks looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Here we are late in the fourth quarter, and this is what this game has come down to. Every possession is going to count, and this could be the one right here. Get to that quickly. He gets hit out of bounds.
Right around the 32-yard line.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. He's knocked out of bounds at the 37-yard line. Setting up blockers, a running back's got it on the screen. He's at the 40, and he's tackled at the 35-yard line. Can't connect. Incomplete. From the 35-yard line. Second down. In the shotgun and five wideouts. And he throws it away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
We have less than a minute to go. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. The defense is making great plays here late in the fourth quarter in a tie ball game. And the question now is which offense can rise to the occasion. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. He's looking for six. You know, there's so many times that you can crack in a situation like that, and they didn't. They come up with the stop of the ball game here this late. Late here in the fourth quarter now in a tie football game. And it looks like, barring another score, we might be headed to overtime. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. It's second and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. Steps up, and he's sacked for a loss. Finally shoved out at the 8. So it looks like four quarters wasn't enough. We're heading to overtime. And here we are. We played four quarters, and we still don't have a winner, so we go to overtime. He flings it.
Football. I score. Now let's see if you can respond. Great teams always find a way to come through.
And he adds the extra point.
10 to go. Ball on the 25. And down he goes, right around the 24-yard line. The 17-yard line. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Nice run there. Slings it, and he's tackled right away. Second and seven. Ball on the 9. Makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss.
This is college football. All you need is one foot down to be able to make this catch. This time, the wide receiver is just too close to the boundary, not allowing himself to get either his left or right foot down.
This one's in the books, and we saw a great one here today. Washington State, 28. Syracuse, 21. So that wraps things up for us. 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.